Hey Wranglords, I'm Dino, and this is Wrangler Studios, and this week a mate hit me up about ways to improve his bar chords and just in general finger strength. So I picked this song, which is by my favourite band, Modest Mouse, and the song's called Float On. This song is off the album Good News for People Who Love Bad News, and it's one of my favourite albums, so let's get into it. This song doesn't really use full bar chords, but it's a good song to build up your finger strength. So start off by flattening your first finger over the 6th fret of our first 3 strings. And the strum pattern we're going to be using is down, 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 up, up, down, 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 up. Down, 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 up, up, down, 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 up. The first down, we're going to have our first finger flat, and then we're going to hammer on our middle finger into this 2nd string. Then continue on your strum pattern as normal. Then we're just removing that middle finger and doing that strum pattern again. Then this time we're going to hammer on our middle finger and our 3rd finger at the same time. So hammering on the 2nd string and the 3rd string respectively. And then back to just our 1st finger. And that's it for the rhythm guitar for pretty much the whole song. Onto this lead riff. We start off by playing an F sharp major arpeggio, which is 3rd finger on this 11th fret of our 3rd string. And we play that note. Then we're going to jump down and play the 11th fret of our 2nd string. Then we're going to play the 9th fret of our 1st string. Then back to our 3rd finger. Then we're going to stay on this 2nd string. And we're playing our 1st finger on this 9th fret. And then straight back to our 3rd finger on our 11th fret. So that whole first bit of that riff. And then we do a bit of a rhythmic thing on this 11th fret. Try and practice alternating picking with your right hand as well throughout this riff. Then the only thing that changes in this riff is our first note. So instead of playing this 11th fret, we're going to play this 10th fret the second time round. The rest of the riff is exactly the same. Then instead of this 10th fret, we're going to start off on our 8th fret. Rest of the riff is exactly the same. Now we're at the tail of the riff, and we're going to just play this 11th fret on this 2nd string 6 times. Then we play our 9th fret, and then our 7th fret. So that whole riff again. Hope you enjoyed this lesson, guys. Stay safe and stay creative.